Said this is the easier side of fins and things, which is true.
Right. Well, we got some serious climate here.
The lift is Rough Country.
Gotcha. Nice. You know, it's funny because Rough Country, like, honest on there, but I know that we don't have the camera on it, but we have the module to change all the electronics and stuff.
Yeah, the camera's only $175.
Yeah, that's not bad at all. Hey, so also, thank you for drawing up this stuff. It's a little sandy up here, but it all seems pretty grippy, so it should be alright.
Is the window open okay?
The window's fine. I was going to roll down mine.
Okay.
As soon as the temperature comes up, we'll take the lift the top off, so. Mm-hmm. Wiggly, bumpy.
Okay.
Quite a bit whenever ranges come through here and things get beat up and changed, so it might take me just a little second. I'm gonna get out and check everything out, make sure it's all still good, and then we will crawl on down nice and easy.
He's gonna get out, he said.
Yeah.
Great job.
rubbing. I heard the rubbing.
Really?
That rear tire rubbed.
Well, it didn't seem like it did. Oh, on the inside maybe?
Yeah.
So this part here, just leave it manual mode, second gear, then just kind of let it crawl down.
We have a crawly. Doesn't he have a crawly?
He's got a crawly too, but this is too short to bother. Yeah, we're just over there.
Yep. Yes, we were. This was the one you were going to have me drive?
Mm-hmm.
This part here, it's not hard at all. It's just a bit of a drop, about 3 feet in front of me. And it's going to go nice and slow. With the 33s, I don't think you'll have an issue as far as hitting the trailer hitch in the back, but it might tap just a little bit. Right about there.
Where it slides?
Yeah. See, right there. There, where you go
down. Oh, I see.
And then if you go a little bit more to the left than where I was, it should be a little bit better on that as well.
To the left.
I'll keep an eye on you as you're coming down.
Yikes.
Just a hit. Bumper looks good though.
It'd give me an excuse to replace it.
See, I wouldn't want to
don't
do that.
Tell me that. I'll find you a new one real quick.
So what exactly hit?
I assume the bumper hit.
Because his didn't.
No.
We're going through this section here. It's, just fine. You're going to kind of close to that tree on the left side, but not too close, of course.
Because there's a hole. How come he's gotten quieter on that?
It's just, he's driving it. Struggle to fall. You roll the back one again. You want a little air.
This section here, we got three little downhill parts that we can choose from. I think we'll probably go down the fun one if you guys are okay with that.
That sounds like a plan.
came on your own, I wouldn't know where to go. Would you?
Again, there's three paths. I mean, yeah, it's not a problem.
Because you don't really see tires.
The what? Black is the tires, dear.
Front. You're in first gear?
Yeah.
With your foot on the brake?
So what angle we at?
We're
at
straight up. Go right down to the button.
22. This is good. That's a little better. 32. okay.
Okay.
Not a Razor, it's called an Odes. It's a four-door, you know, 1,000cc.
Oh, that's great. That's awesome. I kind of like side-by-sides. They were a little bit weird to me at first when I first got them, but they're growing on me a little by little.
Yeah, they're kind of obnoxious at times.
Yeah, but they're loud, they're not that comfortable, but they will go almost anywhere.
Yes, they will. Hey, so this part here, we're going to get up here and kind of turn to the right just a little bit, trying to figure out the best way to get through here without tapping your brake on this rock in front of us. Just go nice and slow, just kind of keep an eye out for this rock on
that one.
I see it there, yep.
About there is where you might touch, but you might also not touch. So if you hold off to the left a little bit, it'll be a little bit less of a hole there. But I'll hop out, keep an eye on you.
He's going to get out.
Far to the left side. Yep. And then go ahead and keep going forward.
Oh yeah, because there's a big hole right there.
Keep coming. Yeah, keep going a little bit to the driver's side.
Driver.
There you go. Just crawl over that rock right there. And then once you get up here, you're going to turn this way and kind of hold off of this little hole here. Just go nice and slow and let the tires do a little bit of the work. Stay turning to the driver's side a little bit more. There you go. And now go ahead and turn to the right. That should be perfect. Look at that.
Do not enter.
He's got a big radio.
Yeah. Alright, and then crawl over these ones, should be just fine. Yeah, the last time I brought a stock JL up here one time, and in my head, it was the first time I had brought a non-Jeep of ours up here. Again, right there, just go ahead and take it nice and slow, let your tires do the work. But I brought them up, and I didn't even think about it, and they just smashed.
One way.
Alright, this is where the one way section starts. We're going to go up here like this, and then we're going to turn left to go up where those arrows are. So.
That's funny. Yeah. One way sign. Oncoming emergency vehicles?
Well, again, if somebody's doing a recovery, that's him chirping, not me.
It is?
Yeah, it was him chirping.
And it looks like we've got a few raises. They're coming up on us. Pull over here to the left a little bit and let them pass by. Just because they're a little quicker on us and I want to put pressure on you guys.
Main trail.
Well, where are they going?
Looks like they don't know that that's the one way. Well, find out.
Guess that Jeep doesn't either.
Alright. Well, we'll keep on cruising. That is it's a bypass that comes back to court.
Oh, that's what
the sand flaps are. If you're on this trail and you want to exit early, that's the way you would come back out to the radio tower. But it's not a two-way, so that'll be fun for them.
Too bad you didn't have your phone with a picture.
I know, right? I can find a picture of one that looks similar on Google. I have found one the other day, but it doesn't do it justice.
You have
this
to tell
here, just go nice and slow. Again, that frame, if I get close to the thing. We're going to go up to the right there on that. It's fun. It's a little bit of a puddle here on the left, but shouldn't affect the traction very much at all. So.
we're good.
I figured you guys are doing a great job. You know what you're doing, so.
First gear?
Yeah. Camera makes it nice.
I mean, honestly, without it, I would be freaking out.
We would be getting out.
You would have a spotter?
Yeah. That front camera makes that easy.
Yeah, that's fair. I'm a little jealous, not gonna lie. I might have to talk my boss into buying one of those for the front to add.
Yes, you did. Thank you. Where'd that red Jeep go?
It's back there.
Is it?
Yeah. That's a rental basher.
Yeah, I was gonna say, it sounds like something's hitting pretty hard somewhere in the front, but guys, they're probably one of my favorite people to work with. As far as like customer service and stuff goes, they're super nice.
But you could definitely tell that had the turbo in it, because it was had the whine.
Yeah, that's honestly, the turbo four-cylinder that we have, similar to that one, is a lot of fun to drive. It's quick, it's fun. On the highway anyway and stuff like that. And off-road, it gets a little weird if you get into the turbo at all, because it surprises you. I'm sure you guys with the diesel, I don't have that problem too with your turbo, but they're a lot of fun. Our 2-liter had quite a few issues as far as like warranty work goes, but it's always fun to drive.
Yeah, the turbo in here is reasonably smooth, so it's not that bad. Although if you get it much over about 1800 RPM, it wants to jump on it pretty hard.
Yeah, that's fair. We, ours, the 2-liter, it's fun. But yeah, if you get it anywhere above, 2000, 2500 RPM, it kicks in pretty good, and it's quick, and for low, it jumps on you, but it's fun. So it's not one of the ones that we rent out. We only rent out the 3.6s and 3.6 gas engines. Easier.
Not to worry about anybody spooling them.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's got a big dip.
No, that's a Jeep.
Is it? Yeah. I thought it was a Jeep, but
that's
it's narrow.
That's an old CJ, yeah.
Okay.
CJ.
I think Dale sent me pictures of his.
His is a CJ.
Down stuff like this, you can drop that down into that manual mode and stuff, and make it a little bit easier to control throttle wise. Not that you need any help, but it makes it a little easier. But scroll through here, it does kind of crawl for a little while on these rocks, and then we move up to the bigger rocks and some skinny rocks, and all kinds of rocks. So
good to know.
No, I'm looking for Dale's pictures today. Hey, you don't want to go that way. Yeah, not good.
We can still hear you. He's got the alert now on. All right, push the button, alert.
Huh?
Crawling down this part again, that manual mode will help, but let's just hang on to the right side. Just kind of follow where I go and take your time. But slow, hang on that left side, gets real dippy into that tree. So left, hang on to the right, and crawl down nice and easy.
Okay. Because I think when we get out here, the ridges
look like fins.
Yeah. Drop off right here.
Having a hard time getting up that hill. I'm looking at him. See him?
No, you can't see him.
See him?
Oh, there he is.
Watch, he's gonna hit it.
Take some air out of the tires. They didn't air down.
Crawl right, so we're ready to go up here. We're going to turn to the right and crawl down. It's going to feel a little bit strange
He might have been trying to climb that.
Yeah, I think he was. I don't know why. Is it Cam, I guess?
It got onto the turbo there.
Huh?
It popped onto the turbo.
It did?
Awesome. Good job, guys.
That's
kind of skinny.
Still enough room for a sign over there, dear. Somebody's dripping oil.
Huh?
Somebody's dripping oil.
Really?
Yeah, you can see it every once in a while. Not him.
Oh, no, I know.
Right there by that light right there.
I see it. That's not good. Yeah, that's a lot of it right there.
One of those two guys is dripping something.
Yeah, I saw that too. I wonder, hopefully it's just like cooler water or something. It's not anything fluid wise. So it sucks. If you go far left over here, you go next to this, on the left side of that white tree there. Nice. I see smiles. That's a good sign.
Yeah, I didn't get hit.
That's what I was keeping an eye out for. I was like, I'll make sure. But you guys are doing perfect. So good job.
Yeah, I see why it's one lane.
Fins, these are fins.
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 Oh.
That's a fin down there, see?
Oh. In there.
Somebody had a transmission problem at one point or another.
Right there. Lost their tranny. Oldest is a boy, he's 35, married, and we have a granddaughter, 7, from him, and they live in Mesa.
Which is about 8 miles away.
And just, you know, they can stop by anytime. They're watching our dogs while we're gone. And we have a daughter who's 32, and she lives in New York, and she's married, no children.
I have a niece is 7, and it's a fun age. Like, under 10, they're all, they have the most energy in the whole world.
This is true.
Yes, she does. I can attest to that. We don't get to see her very often because of COVID. I'm a nurse, so I take care of hospice patients. And so my daughter-in-law is very strict about avoidance. And so we don't get to see her very often. And when we do, it's outside and with masks on and very strict. So, but I understand her concern.
Yeah, that's how my whole family all lives near Chicago. And my sister, I have 2 sisters, one lives in Chicago. Not married, but long-term boyfriend. No kids, and then my other sister has 3 kids, so I have 2 nieces and a nephew.
Yeah, we were babysitting her a couple times a week, and she goes to school right by our house, and now she's homeschooling her, and she worked for the zoo, and they furloughed them for a long time, and now they laid her off, so it's been a tough year for them.
Yeah, I guess part of me is just hoping the 2021 is a little more comfortable. We'll see how it goes.
True that. Eventually they're gonna have to do something, I guess.
It'd be okay.
Eventually it'll be more fun. I'll see on that side.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Maybe come at more of an angle this way.
I don't know. I see what he means. He needs to go that way. He needs to turn his tires that way.
Yeah, you need to go.
Hold on 1 second.
He doesn't have his thing on him.
You probably should have come at it a little more straighter. A little more to the left.
He doesn't have his thing right.
Yeah, I'm gonna back up and redo it real quick.
No,
he's got it. That left tire might be, he still needs to go to the passenger, I think.
Yeah, he still needs to.
Now he needs to go passenger.
Pretty precarious. See how?
Yeah, see, it did fine. We're narrower than him, so we're
good. We are?
Yeah.
Man, that is narrow.
Alright, I'm gonna hop out and guide you guys, and that way you don't have to worry about doing that. That part's always just real sketchy, as it gets skinnier and skinnier every day. So, should be all good. Give me 1 second and switch radios, and I will be right there.
He's on the big radio, that's why.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. It's more of a mental thing, I think, coming through here, because
yeah. You
probably drive straight through and not even worry about it, but it's just easier to have someone looking at you, so. Cool. Come on, go ahead and straighten out towards me. You guys can crawl through. You're going to want to just kind of keep your eye on this ledge here, and you can kind of turn to the passenger side a little more. And straighten out. A little bit more this way, and just straighten out a little bit more. You crawl right through it. A little bit more to the passenger side. Awesome. Go ahead and straighten out. Go right up towards me. Perfect. It's gonna feel weird, but crawl right through.
It crawls in first gear and low. I don't have my foot on the gas even.
Really?
Yeah. It's doing its own thing.
Yeah, you're right. That diesel is, I guess it is low. I didn't
think about that. The torque, it's a torque. It's just a torque unit.
I was going to say, second gear would be super high for you guys then. Sorry about that.
Yeah, that's all right. That's not a problem.
Awesome. You guys are doing good. There's some dirt bikers behind us. We'll pull over a little faster.
No problem.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just easier when there's someone in front of you looking at
us.
But that's the only part of this trail I don't like.
I see why.
All righty. We'll pull over and let you guys pass by and then keep on cruising.
Yeah, this Jeep just did low. Just
we'll pull forward to the top here, and then we'll find a spot that's a little wider.
They'll do when that gets really skinny.
It looks like they're going to hang out up there for a little while. We'll just keep on cruising. If they get close to us, we'll pull over.
Say okay.
Okay.
It's the land of ups and downs and overs.
Mm-hmm. Would you have wanted to do this by yourself?
Yeah, I wasn't too worried about fence and things.
No. Of course, here comes the dirt bikes.
That's okay. That you need hill descent with diesel because it's just the engine back pressure is
maybe not on this kind of hill. What was the ones we used it on?
Coming down the steps there at Black Bear. Yeah. I need a pin ejector. Mm-hmm. Probably really didn't need four low.
Well, see, at least they did that, because you wouldn't know where to go, you know? You're sparkling.
Hmm?
That was flashing.
What was? Oh, yeah.
That's okay.
Sound good coming on down that thing right there. You're going to feel a little bit of a bump coming down. You'll feel it about 3 feet. Just crawl right over it. It's not a big bump. It's surprising if you're going too fast. There you go. And then we'll hang out up here and let those guys pass by.
Okay.
She didn't want to go up that hill. She's going to wait for him over here.
Alright, so this part here, second gear, or well, third gear, I guess, for you guys. Or first, if you want to go nice and slow, but take your time and crawl right up nice and easy.
I guess she wanted a running start at it, huh? She's coming after us. That's interesting.
She cheated.
Where'd she go?
Hey, Darren. Mm-hmm. She was a smart one. You could have gone through there.
Go straight.
We'll follow.
We'll follow you.
Gas.
Take your time, dude. Don't want to die halfway up the hill. Squirrely whirly.
That's looks like a lot of work. I figured I would just let him go
forward. Definitely is a lot of work.
As the day goes on. They're a little pushy. That's one thing about razors and that. They're a little pushy.
They want to go faster.
Man, they don't appreciate Jeeps. Somebody's up on the top doing a little mechanical fix, right?
We could have made that one.
Mm-hmm.
We could have made that one.
Yeah. That's not a problem. Maybe they should try that one.
We could have made that one.
Yeah, the approach angle of that one is, for razors, great. For the Jeep, that bumper just smacks right into the wall, and it just, every time.
Are they going up there? Yep, they did.
Yeah.
It's not really a fun little section of the trail. It's called Kenny's Climb. The reason it's called Kenny's Climb is because Kenny, the gentleman who climbed it, yeah, those razors, they've got almost no approach angle. I think a ton of approach angle, I guess is the way to put it, but it's right up that bumper, so it's nice, but definitely different.
A good place to break down.
I just shoot the breeze because there's nothing out front. That's the cooler. Unless it's dealing with a shock or something.
they stop up here. That's funny.
I'm going to pass by the Jazz one more time. And go ahead and follow me right through there. Should be this way.
It's a tour.
A tour?
See the front, see the Moab tour?
Yeah. He likes our Jeep. Huh?
In first gear manual, in the manual mode in first gear, I don't even have to use the brake.
Man, I want that diesel so bad.
It says wrong way, yeah. There's a splash down at the other end.
I'm gonna back up just a little bit.
Okay.
On that side.
You're fine.
That was always the one main fear that I always had was the inside race. Like, yep, right and left. Much more comfortable now, but when I first started, it was like I would freeze.
Yeah, but we got cheaters now. We've got the descent angle, we've got pitch and roll angles.
Oh, I know. It makes it so much easier.
They didn't take that climb.
No, I don't think so. We just don't want to brush them with the new brush. So.
She must have dumped it.
Huh?
A Lou-mobile behind us.
What is that?
Lewis. Lou's. Oh. Terex.
Oh, Lou's Terex.
I guess it's a little sandy, but again, that first gear, or if you want to use second gear, go ahead and climb up this nice and easy right behind me.
Is she okay?
She's fine.
Okay.
Okay.
She's walking back.
Oh,
okay. A little on the sandy side, so once you guys get up, just kind of let your tires clean themselves out as you're crawling up and go ahead and nice and slow. Yep, you're good. Perfect. Keep going.
a bunch of torque.
Yay! Yeah!
It hopped up on that torque too much.
To have such a problem.
To have such a problem.
That was great. I'm spinning tires always, not spinning, but like sliding them just a little bit to get the sand off. It's a little bit nerve-wracking to most people because they're like, oh no, it's just sliding, I'm going to fall. But you guys are doing a great job. I appreciate it. You guys are making my job very easy. So, nice.
Get a refund?
Go ahead, Doolittle.
Yes,
we will.
And don't stink. And don't smell too bad.
Yeah.
Don't smell like gasoline. Ooh, we get to go in a mud puddle.
I told you, we get to go in a mud puddle.
It's easy in a Jeep.
Definitely. Especially one with that level of gear. I'm very jealous. No, it's fun. Actually, the water out here doesn't affect our traction at all on the rocks, which is kind of nice. The rock is so porous, it almost acts like a sandpaper for us. But so, as long as it's not covering the sand, which that one was, but it's a bit of an exception to the rule, but usually it's actually grippier when it's wet than it is when it's dry.
shift manually at the end of that kind of load.
Oh, so he's got total plates underneath, huh?
Yeah.
Except for on the gas tank.
Yeah, not gas tank. That's it. The gas tank's the one down the side, the long one down the side.
Oh, what's in the back then?
Muffler.
So what's that tank?
What tank?
Oh, that's the exhaust. Never mind.
Muffler.
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 Street queen.
Well, then I can't come with you. We made it up the hill finally.
Hmm?
We figured out a way to get her up the hill.
Something in here smells warm, yeah. Like
yeah.
My jacket or something that stinks.
All the temps look okay.
Good off-road maps. Off-road pages, not maps. Mm-hmm.
Three on your dash mean in the
man. manual, third gear.
Oh, okay. Well, there you go.
So I know that mountain biking and running are out of the question, but what other kind of hobbies do you guys do?
We actually have a houseboat on Lake Powell, so water skiing is something we do.
Water skiing sounds like a lot more manual labor than you sounded interested in doing.
It is. It's getting up is the tough part. Once you're up, it's not that bad.
Oh, well, that's fair. Yeah, that makes sense to you.
The tough part's getting up without getting your beer wet.
Probably need cup holders on life jackets.
Yes.
Yeah, but that would get your beer wet then.
Well, you gotta pop it open once you're there.
Oh, yeah, I guess you're right. That's fair. Perfect. Isn't really the wrong way to go down that, so you just wherever you want, crawl on down nice and easy.
Some people a day, as long as they don't pour hard water on it or squirt it hard with squirters.
Yeah, that's right.
Rain falls harder than the water, so yeah, no. In a million years, those dinosaur tracks will still be there.
True, true.